Hello and welcome to this very unique back to school night. Thank you so much for joining me virtually. As you know by now, I am Miss Lassalle. I am so excited to be sharing some information with you tonight about second grade, about my class, and about our school year. So let's get started. So again, welcome to back to school night. Let's get started. So here's a little overview of our presentation for tonight. I'm going to tell you a little about myself and my class. We're also going to review the procedures in second grade, talk about curriculum and learning goals, and also just communication and the next steps for the school year. So I am Miss Lassalle. I was born and raised in the East Bay area. I went to San Jose State and got my bachelor's in child development. Then I went on to get my master's at Santa Clara University in teaching. I also received my teaching credential there. I'm a second year teacher. This is my first year at Gardner, but my second year in the district. Last year I was at Santa Rita. Here's a few pictures from my first year of teaching, the beginning of this year, and my family. So here's a little bit about my teaching philosophy. I believe that relationships come first. I think that it's so important for students to build a strong bond with me and our other classmates, and that students will definitely learn best when they feel happy and comfortable with their teacher in their class. I also have high expectations for my students. I think that rigor is important and I want them to succeed. Along with that, I think it's important to have a lot of warmth towards your class so that they feel encouraged to push themselves and perform their best. One other thing that means a lot to me is promoting a growth mindset. I think that it's really important for students at this age to learn that it's okay to make mistakes, and it's actually a great way to learn. So those are some things that are important to me and that I will be focusing on with my students this year. Attendance. This year, there are four tiers of attendance while we are working online or in a hybrid model. Attendance is submitted at the end of the day each day, and it's based on participation in live meetings as well as completing those key assignments. So I have a little breakdown of the four types of attendance here. DL1 is what we're shooting for each day. It means that your student is showing up for live meetings and they are also turning in their work. A D2 means that they're missing some meetings and maybe missing some work. A DL3 means that they were not in any of their live meetings, but they showed some example of how they were doing work that day. And of course, a DL0 means no attendance and no work, which means I have no proof that they were doing anything for school that day. So each day we're shooting for a DL1. If your child is sick or will be out of class for the day, the same procedures as always apply. Be sure to contact the office and let them know what's going on. All right, let's talk about some of our classroom procedures. So this year, we are going to be grading on our regular LASD mastery scale, which looks like this. Key assignments are going to be used for both formative and summative assessments. So some key assignments will be scored and others will not, but they will always get feedback on those key assignments. We will be using key assignments to help us assess for report cards. On report cards, you will also see the learning behaviors section. These are the learning behaviors that we as a district are passionate about developing in our students. And these are scored on a rarely, sometimes, consistently, or independently range. So the goal here is to land in that independent range by the end of the school year. Material pickup days. These are really important. So every first and third Thursday each month, you will come to school to pick up materials for your child. I will always make sure to remind you of this in my Friday email, so keep an eye out for that. The pickups are from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. You can come anytime in between that window. There's no grade level requirements or anything like that. Remember that this will exclude holidays, and I will always let you know if on a material pickup day, second graders don't have anything to pick up. So I'll shoot out an email if that's the case, but assume that you need to come on the first and the third Thursday of each month from 11 to 1, unless I tell you otherwise. All right, Google Classroom. So the two main things that are most important about Google Classroom is that all assignments will be submitted through it. So if you have a key assignment due, that means that it needs to be submitted through Google Classroom. Please support your child with uploading these tasks as they count for both attendance and they help me to see where they're at. You can also access all of the learning plans from the Google Classroom. You can find them on our schedule linked, but you can also find them in our Google Classroom. The learning plans are always posted under the topics in the classwork section of Google Classroom. All right, here's a little bit about our Google Meet plan for our online learning. So again, I have four different types of meets that you have seen some of so far and you'll see some of in the future. Whole class meets are typically at the beginning of each subject area. We use this time to introduce the topics, watch videos, or prep materials. These are happening every day, probably 4 to 5 times per day. We also have half class Google Meets. We'll use these as needed. These are for times when I want to do an activity that we can do with a medium-sized group, but I can't do it with everyone at once. And then small group meets. We've been doing small groups since the second week of school. These are usually 1 to 3 times per day for your kids. This is where we really review topics, do activities that support the learning plan, and they're my main way of checking for understanding. I will also be conducting one-on-one meetings as needed. These are to support students individually, meet them where they're at academically, as well as build that social emotional strength and relationship with them. I'm going to give you a brief overview of our learning goals and the curriculum that we will be using this year. So in Reading Workshop, we use the Teachers College Reading Project by Lucy Calkins. Here I've listed some of the important learning goals. I will be sharing this PowerPoint with you, so if you want to read through them more closely, you can. Some of the big ideas are word decoding, vocabulary development, fluency, and understanding figurative language, to name a few. Writing Workshop, our curriculum is also Teachers College Writing Project by Lucy Calkins. There are a few big ideas in writing this year. We're going to work on narratives, we're also going to work on research papers, and even poetry, where we'll be practicing figurative language and line breaks, rhythm, and visualization. Phonics Workshop is also Teachers College. They are the Phonics Units of Study by Lucy Calkin. Some big ideas and learning goals for phonics this year include fostering a love of language, decoding words, choosing interesting words, and understanding the meaning of more challenging words. Math Workshop. For math this year, we are using SFUSD Mathematics Curriculum. The big ideas and the learning goals of our math workshop include extending understanding of base 10 notation, building fluency with addition and subtraction, using standard units of measurement, and describing and analyzing shapes. Science and Social Studies. Our science curriculum uses a blend of different curriculums alongside our district-developed standards-based science units of study. We use Next Generation Science Standards, FOSS Science by the University of California, and Mystery Science. For social studies, we are using Pearson and Scott Forsman alongside district-developed standards-based social studies units of study. Each day, we also have a morning meeting and a closing circle. These are required meetings at the beginning and end of each day, and they're a great chance for us all to connect socially and emotionally and check in with each other. You can see here my organization for my morning meeting and my closing circle. On Tuesdays and Fridays, we have PE with Mr. Ortman. Make sure that you join Mr. Ortman's Google Classroom and join in on those meetings at these assigned times on our assigned days. You can find the PE Google Meet link in Mr. Ortman's Google Classroom under classwork. It's labeled Gardner Bullis second grade. Remember that PE is a required activity and Mr. Ortman is taking attendance each day, so please be sure to have your child log on. Los Altos Art Docents and Living Classroom. The Los Altos Art Docents, as well as our Living Classroom coordinators, have developed a really rich curriculum of online lessons for distance learning. It's awesome. These lessons are going to take place typically on Wednesdays during independent work time. The expectation is that they will be completed. Living Classroom is also going to be hosting some live instruction via Google Meet with all of second grade. I have dates for this that will be announced soon. Communication. So as of right now, I am still in need of room parents. Assuming that we go back to school in the hybrid model, each cohort A and B, we'll need 1 or 2 room parents. Please contact the room parent lead through the PTA if you're interested. Some of the responsibilities are planning classroom celebrations if we are able to, communicating with the Room 7 families, and helping me as needed when you're available. Friday emails. These are important. Every Friday, I will send out a Friday email. I'll give you a brief overview of the student learning for that week in the recap. I'll also include important updates and reminders and schedules. So each of these things will be in my Friday emails, and it's really important that we read them. Thanks, guys. Here are some ways to contact me. All right, here are some ways to contact me. Email is definitely the quickest and my preferred method of communication. You can also contact me through Google Classroom, contact the school office, and they'll reach out to me. Or you can call or text me if it is an emergency. This is not my preferred form of communication, but I want to make myself available to help throughout the day. And if that works for you, it works for me. I know that we are not live together tonight, but if you have any questions or comments about the presentation or school in general, please don't hesitate to email me for clarification. I'm always one quick email away. Thank you so much for joining me for Back to School Night 2020. I know that this year is a little strange and very unique, but I'm still really looking forward to working with you and your children this year. I really appreciate you being here. I hope that you have a great rest of your night, and I can't wait to connect with you again soon. Bye.